Hello Scrappers, today we will do an experiment. There are quite many videos on the internet saying that you can dissolve this protective coverage of the capacitors and of some other ceramic elements like this with dimethyl sulfoxide, DMSO. So I bought one bottle. I bought it from Germany. That's the shipment documentation. And that's the price. It's 1 liter, 23.80 euro. So it came yesterday. Here is the package. Let me open it. I hope I will not punch the bottle. But let's see what's inside. Here we go. That's my 1 liter DMSO, 99.9%. I'll take the bottle out and let's see. So I will pick one element of each type and I'll put even one BGA from RAM, and I will also remove the cap of this BGA and put it. I want to do an experiment because in some videos they say DMSO is good for ceramics. In other videos, they say it's good for plastics. Usually, for this black stuff, we use concentrated nitric acid. But now I will put it in DMSO and let's see the result. So I'll put a couple of capacitors also and one of these. And let's put one of these. Let's put one of the RAM. And I will also put one of these ceramic ones. So more or less, let's put this big one. More or less, we have a couple of different types of capacitors. These are good quality Bulgarian ones, blue and brown. These are some from modern boards and two BGAs and one ceramic from this type that we find frequently on our boards. Next step is I will just cover them with DMSO and we go to the, let me check the smell, almost no smell. So I'll just cover them like this, not too much. Okay, Scrappers, so that's the same solution. I put it on my heater here and let's start heating to 50, 55, 60 degrees, no more. And let's wait. I'll just start the ventilation and forget it for about 10 minutes. Let's come back in 10 minutes and see what's going on here. Okay guys, so let's see what's going on here. You see the coloration changes slowly of some of the capacitors, so maybe reaction started. That's my magnetic stirrer and heater, so you can see I switched the heating and it's about 60, 70, maybe 80 degrees. I'll try to keep this temperature and to keep the reaction going a little bit faster. But I already see that something is bubbling there and I see some reaction because definitely the color changes of some of the capacitors. So let's wait and see. I will come and check them in 5-10 minutes. So definitely something happens there. I see the color changed of the capacitors, even the liquid is a little bit reddish. So reaction is ongoing and I'll just leave it for another 10 minutes and let's see what will happen. So it's 30 minutes later and as you can see, most of the capacitors inside already started to crack and to expose the inside palladium cores. So also the color is reddish. I think it's reddish because of of this, it was red. So you look at it, when I punch it, what happens? What I will do now? I will move all this stuff here, wash them, and let's check together how DMSO reacted with the protective covering of these capacitors. So, here we go. These are our capacitors that spent at about 30 minutes in DMSO, heated at about probably 80 degrees all the time. And let's see what actually happened, what we have. So, originally we have had these two capacitors, and after 30 minutes in DMSO, that's the result. So let me show you what happens. Maybe they have to stay a little bit more, but I will quickly crack it like this. And show you that actually this nice capacitor . This protective coverage is almost removed, if you can see. Same is here with the big one. So look at the big one. So it started cracking, and you see that it's disposing the internal part. Let's go to this blue ones. Yeah, this is definitely softened, so probably these capacitors, they need more time. Yeah, it's softened because it was solid. Now when I scratch it, I feel it more like a soft plastic, not like a... And what about these chips? Actually, these chips, they were really well cleaned. Nothing. But the most impressive is this capacitor. And this. Just look what happened. Look at this. That's amazing. So, look at this beauty. Do you know what usually people do to remove this protective covering? So, to remove the protective covering, people burn these capacitors. And look at the size of the MLCC. So, this is the MLCC that contains palladium. Look at the size of this MLCC. That's why these capacitors are considered to be really good for palladium recovery. These capacitors are really, really good for palladium recovery. So, for the brown Bulgarian capacitors, great job. For this part here, great job too. Look at this. It was reddish in the beginning. Look at it now. It's completely clean. All the ceramics, all the ceramics that was on top now is disappearing. So let me show you these two examples. Nice MLCC and this ceramic element, they're clean. So for some other, like these yellow ones, maybe we need more time. Maybe we need not 30 minutes, we need 2 hours. But reaction started here. You see that the edges are, I mean, this capacitor cracked, edges are open. So the DMSO can go inside and continue destroying the protective coverage. Here is the same. This one softened, so probably this one needs more time. So what is the conclusion? Conclusion is DMSO is really useful, and in many cases, it's doing great job really quickly because this capacitor was cleaned up, and this was cleaned up in less than 10 minutes. In other cases, you will probably need for these capacitors a longer period of time. You have just to leave it and boil it for maybe 2 hours, and then everything will be clean. So that's what we have. Thanks for watching.